Hi, this is Josh Olson, and this edition of Trailers from Hell is for Texas and Miss Lily. It's John Huston's wonderful western, The Life and Times of Judge Roy Bean, starring Paul Newman. Judge Roy Bean was a real character in the Old West. He was a saloon keeper and a justice of the peace in Val Verde County, Texas, a town that he himself named Vinegaroon. He also called himself the Law west of the Pecos. Bean was a legendary eccentric. He would routinely impose fines on guilty men, and those fines always seemed to work out to be the exact amount of money that those men had on them. He also performed weddings, always ending with, "And may God have mercy on your souls," which I believe is normally reserved for funerals. If one were going to make a movie about this character, it would seem that the best filmmakers for the job, hell, the only filmmakers for the job, would be John Milius and John Huston. Happily, those worthy gentlemen saw their responsibility and acted accordingly.
Do you swear solemn allegiance and vow to uphold the honor of Lily Langtry?
I do!
For Texas and Miss Lily!
For Texas!
The movie is a mad hodgepodge of tones and styles and moods, a wild and bawdy tall tale about a larger-than-life character. Some people have problems with it, but I have none. I worship at its altar.
I am a bean, and we beans just don't know when we're licked.
This here's Sam Dodd, Judge. Genuine murderer.
Do you have anything to say before we find you guilty?
I'm not guilty of nothing.
The movie is chock full of wonderful cameos. Anthony Perkins, Roddy McDowell, Ned Beatty, Tab Hunter, Michael Sarrazin, Anthony Zerb, and many, many others. Among the standouts, Jacqueline Bisset, who is gorgeous in the latter portion of the film as Bean's daughter, appropriately tough and badass. And the movie marked the screen debut of Victoria Principal. Two of my favorite cameos, though, are director John Huston himself playing the legendary mountain man Grizzly Adams, although his performance is a far cry from the family-friendly TV star the character would become a few years later. Personally, I'd have enjoyed a series based on the character as played by Huston. But the most notable of them all is this one right here. It's Stacy Keach as Bad Bob. Not Dirty Bad Bob, the Mexican, but the original Bad Bob, the albino. When I saw this movie as a child, Bad Bob scared the ever-loving shit out of me. Keach gives a demented, twisted, hilarious, and terrifying performance. It's a wonderful scene in the film. I don't want to give anything away, but the climax of the Bad Bob scene has been homaged, reused, and ripped off so many times, it's ridiculous. But this is where you saw it first, and that's all I'm going to say on that.
The ancient Greeks worshipped the feet of Aphrodite. They loved mortal women as well. The same goes for me.
I shall pray for you, Bean. This land abounds in ruffians and varlets. Their numbers are legion, their evil skills commensurate.
In spite of all its violence and depravity, the movie is one of the more sentimental in John Huston and screenwriter John Milius' oeuvres.
Is that a bullet hole through my heart?
Yes, it is, ma'am. They was wild men in those days.
Who did it?
Snake River Rufus Kyle did that, I believe.
Yeah. What became of him?
Judge shot him. Dead. Then he fined him for some other crimes. And then later we hanged him.
Most appropriate. The judge must have been quite a character.
Bean was considered a handsome man for his time, so the casting is actually appropriate. Everything Bean does, he does in the name of Texas and Miss Lily Langtree, who was a great actress back in the day. Judge Roy Bean never got to meet her, though, unfortunately, but she does appear in a scene in the film towards the end, played by Ava Gardner, who's absolutely perfectly cast. Newman's performance is wonderful. He's tough and salty and gruff. He can do the most utterly unsympathetic things and never loses our sympathy. He's thoroughly likable, even when he's being despicable. That is why God made movie stars. It's a love letter to a time that has passed, a time that, in fact, may never have really been. But boy, it should have.
Pour it over me, sweeter than mine.